lot of factors to look at when you're evaluating someone's pain and suffering claim. It's what is the injury? To what extent is that injury permanent? What type of medical treatment does that person require, and are they going to need to undergo for the rest of their lives? What are the things that they were able to do before an incident take place that they can no longer do? What types of things did they enjoy doing with their spouses, with their family members, that they can no longer do?